Hey guys, welcome to another AltRider video. I'm Don Hogan, the lead designer here, and we're going to be taking a look at some accessories that we believe in that we sell here at AltRider specifically for the Super Tenere. This time we'll be talking about the Rox Risers. It's a 2-inch rise, and they're fully adjustable. It's an incredible product, and I'm going to have Jeremy LeBreton, the president, actually talk through some of the ergonomic benefits and just some other considerations, and then after that I'll run you through a quick install tutorial.
So we're going to talk about bar risers, and like with every one of the products that we do, we always take a look and see what's on the market, see what's already there, how does it form, or how well does it function, what's its price point. And we got to say, when it comes to bar risers, Rox has done a really good job. Twofold, not only are you getting, of course, the rise that you're looking for, but in and around a similar competitive price point, you're getting this flexibility so that you can have the bars back or you can have the bars forward. So I'm going to take a quick second to talk just a little bit about ergonomics. A lot of riders don't really realize how important and how big an impact ergonomics can have on you. Because, of course, nobody coached you or nobody made you aware of it, so you didn't know how much less of a fatiguing ride you could have if you just had your bike set up properly. And so we'll talk a little bit more about that when we do the setup on this bike. But back to the risers. It's a really nice product. Comes anodized aluminum, it's billet. And it's, of course, this central mounting position here that allows me to, if I'm a shorter guy and I've got shorter arms, I'm probably going to want to have more rake. I'm still getting the rise that helps me in the standing riding position. That was the whole thing of why we're doing this, is bar risers become pretty important for the off-road rider so that he gets into a standing position. The whole reason we're standing is we can be much more responsive to what the bike's doing, because we get this little bit of what you consider almost like a room of insurance, let the bike move. Whereas if you're sitting down and when the bike moves, you're going with it and you don't really have that insurance or that tolerance there. So back to a short guy riding stand-up, now he can bring the bars closer to him, still keep the bars in the correct position for his wrists. Or, of course, if it's a tall guy, he can get the bars way up here, but now because it's a Rox, he can rotate them forward and still have the bars up forward with the rise, allowing him to be in a comfortable position for his wrists and for still in a standing position, which takes a lot of the load off of your lower back. So after you spend a little bit of time figuring out, hey, where does it make most sense for me, both in the location of the bars forward and aft, then really pay attention, though, on the location of where the wrists go. A lot of guys either, not sure how this happens, but every once in a while you'll get on some customers' bikes and you're literally like, ow, man, you probably want to consider clocking your bars back or forward. It's going to take a lot of load off of your wrist based upon which way this angle is going. So there's no fixed setting that's perfect for everybody, but be aware of it and take a couple of minutes and play around with the settings on your bike. You know, a lot of guys just don't spend the time to do that. Then the other thing I want to talk about, we'll go through the installation a little bit in some of the other segments, but when you get done, a lot of guys will put the bar risers on and they're going to go and check for safety. Okay, I've got plenty of length on the cables because none of them stopped before the bar stopped. What I really want to encourage, you know, get off the bike, spend a good bit of time with each one of the cables and follow them down to their, you know, mating point or where their contact point is. Because you never know, it could be one cable that, while it certainly has enough length, it might be riding up against the hard steel edge of a flange, something like that. Or, you know, if you got billet triple clamps, there could be a hard edge there. And while it won't be a problem immediately, 3 months, 3 years later, you could have a potential failure, especially if that's a brake line that it's been rubbing up against. So that's pretty much it on the Rox bar risers.
Now, let's have a look at how to install the Rox risers on your Tenere. Remove the OEM bar clamps on the top. Move your bar out of the way. Place the left and right Rox risers in the bar clamps and start the fasteners. Don't tighten them all the way down just yet. Take the top clamps off the Rox risers and then use the bar to ensure that both are lined up properly. Put the bar in the top of the Rox risers and place the top clamps on and start tightening them. Check the bar position before final tightening. Adjust as needed and tighten everything down when you are satisfied with your riding position. Of course, take your time and inspect all your cables. Finally, just be sure to really check your cables. As Jeremy had mentioned earlier in the video, you want to trace all the cables down, make sure there are no sharp edges that cables are going to be contacting, rotate the bars full lock to full lock, and just make sure that you're totally in the clear before you go and ride this thing, for miles and miles or years. You don't want to end up with a failing brake line. And if you have any further questions or comments about accessories for your Super Tenere, or you just have general questions, we'd love to hear from you. So log into our website and shoot us an email or give us a call.